Hey guys, this is USB Rabada key from Hack5. This is one cool tool, but the thing is, it costs you $45 and that's quite expensive. So in this video, I'm gonna show you something that's gonna do pretty much everything that this Rabada key can do, but under $3. This is the Arduino Pro Micro. This is the Arduino Pro Micro, also known as Arduino Leonardo. That's a micro USB port. As you see, it's quite small. I bought it from AliExpress. I'll link it down below in the description if you guys want to check it out. It has free shipping, but they might take a while to deliver it, depending on your location, of course. Now we'll start off by Googling Arduino IDE. Now this integrated development environment is used to program your Arduino. So we got to download and install. As we are using Windows, I'm going to go with Windows installer. You can use whichever platform you want. You have support for both Linux and macOS. Now click just download. Now I'll just hit cancel as I already have this installed. Let me open it quickly. Arduino. Opening. Yeah. So I will just clear out whatever it's in there. And this is how your environment will look like. And then we'll go to Cytonic.com. And I want to talk about Cytonic. He's the guy who came up with this idea of making a USB Rabada key using Arduino Nano. And he has a YouTube channel. You guys must check it out if you have an interest in hardware, especially Arduino. He has an awesome channel, trust me. Now let's just scroll down and go to this script. Now this is a Ducky script. It gives you a reverse shell. We'll just copy this, but since this is a Ducky script, Arduino won't understand this. So we gotta convert this in a form that Arduino understands. So there's a script called Ducktuino for that. And he has that inside his site. I'm gonna go with this. If you wanna check it out, I'll just list that Ducktuino's link, GitHub link in the description. Now resources, Ducky script converter. And paste it. And hit compile. Now we got our code. Select all and then copy. Now we'll open our Arduino IDE and then paste it in here. Now we gotta change few parameters here, and one such thing is the Netcat download link. I'll mention the download link in the description. So you gotta know what the script does first. The script gives you a reverse shell. Reverse shell, which is if you're listening, the attacking machine should listen using a Netcat. Using Netcat on a specific port. Now I'm gonna go with the IP of 192.168.1.102 and the port 54321. You can use whichever one you want, and I'll mention the Netcat download link in the description. Now you gotta mention that link within the codes. Now I got my link here. As I said before, I'll mention this in the description. Now before we gotta click on upload, and before clicking upload, I wanna plug in my Arduino, obviously. So I'll just plug it in. Now one annoying thing that's gonna happen now is that it's gonna run the script. I mean, not this script, but the script I had programmed in it earlier. So if you're using an Arduino to do this, and you had programmed it earlier and you're gonna reprogram it, when you plug it in, it's gonna run that script on your computer itself. So it's pretty annoying, but you gotta bear with it and wait for it for a few seconds, let it get over, then do your thing. Now go to Tools, Board, Arduino Leonardo, Tools, Port, and my port is COM3. It varies for you, and you gotta check it out. It's just trial and error, COM3, and click upload. Now check the status here, compiling. Wait for it to finish. Let it say done uploading. uploading. Done. Once it says done, I'll just plug it out. Now that we have programmed Arduino and we'll just see a small proof of concept. I'll just plug my Arduino in my computer. And as you see, the script starts running. And within 5 seconds or so, I got the reverse shell. That's how you make a $3 USB rubber ducky. And a special thanks to Cyronic. And hope you guys enjoy this video. Thanks for watching.